I do right because of my conscience, okay? So I do not have to fear something to do right. I do right because it's right, okay?
That's right. How do you know it's right?
How can we know whether something is right or wrong? Where do morals come from? Some might answer that we as individuals should determine our own morality. But think about it. If there is no objective standard for good, then wouldn't everyone consider themselves to be good, including the child molester and the rapist? If morality can mean anything for anyone, then it means nothing for everyone. Others would claim that society determines morality. Within this view, a society such as Nazi Germany could only be quietly observed, not judged, nor opposed. In fact, if Nazi morals were right within Nazi society, there would have been a moral obligation for all Germans to murder innocent people. And obviously, that's not right.
If God does not exist, then objective moral values and duties do not exist. That is to say, if there is no God, then everything becomes relative. Everything is permitted. Premise two, objective moral values and duties do exist. We sense that certain things really are good or evil, right or wrong. And from that, it follows logically and inescapably that three, therefore, God exists.
An agnostic astronomer by the name of Paul Davies from out in Arizona actually posed that question in the New York Times about 10 or so years ago, Bobby. He said, where do the laws of physics come from? He was asking his scientific buddies, and he got a whole bunch of backlash from even posing the question. Because the atheists have no way of explaining where laws come from. Laws come from lawgivers. Why is the universe so orderly? Why is it so precise? Why can we take a rover, build it here on Earth, launch it, put it on a planet 60 million miles away, Mars, with absolute precision? Because we can rely on the laws of nature to do what they do repeatedly over and over again. Well, what's holding all those laws together? Where did they come from? It seems to me the best explanation is a mind. These are orderly laws that remain constant. Everything materially changes. Why don't the laws of nature change? It seems to me because there's a mind behind them. And this is what Paul Davies, an agnostic, was getting at. And his atheistic buddies were very upset about it.
Here a lot of times in the political media where you'll hear people say you cannot legislate morality. How would you respond to somebody who said that?
I would say, first of all, what is morality? Morality is about right and wrong. And when you think about it, all laws legislate morality. Every law says one behavior is right and the opposite behavior is wrong, at least in a legal sense. So all laws legislate morality. The only question is whose morality? Even on the volatile issue of abortion, both sides are trying to legislate morality. Obviously, the pro-life side wants to impose continued pregnancy on the mother. That's a moral position. But the pro-abortion side wants to impose death on the baby whenever abortion is chosen. That is a moral position. Also notice the pro-abortion side says that the father has no moral right to make a choice. The baby obviously has no moral right to life. The only person that has a moral right is the mother. Well, that is a moral position. Every position in politics, virtually, is a moral position. Both sides, conservatives, liberals, everyone in between, are trying to legislate morality. The only question is, whose morality? And the morality I think we ought to legislate is the morality that isn't mine, isn't yours, but ours. The one that was given to us by the Creator, and the one that Thomas Jefferson said is self-evident, that we all understand that there are certain unalienable rights, and the first right is life, because without the right to life, you don't have...
Can you be good without God? Let's find out. Absolutely astounding. There you have it. Undeniable proof that you can be good without believing in God. But wait, the question isn't, can you be good without believing in God? The question is, can you be good without God? See, here's the problem. If there is no God, what basis remains for objective good or bad, right or wrong? If God does not exist, objective moral values do not exist. And here's why. Without some objective reference point, we have no way of saying that something is really up or down. God's nature provides an objective reference point for moral values. It's the standard, against which all actions and decisions are measured. But if there's no God, there's no objective reference point. All we're left with is one person's viewpoint, which is no more valid than anyone else's viewpoint. This kind of morality is subjective, not objective. It's like a preference for strawberry ice cream. The preference is in the subject, not the object. So it doesn't apply to other people. In the same way, subjective morality applies only to the subject. It's not valid or binding for anyone else. So, in a world without God, there can be no evil and no good, nothing but blind, pitiless indifference. God has expressed his moral nature to us as commands. These provide the basis for moral duties. For example, God's essential attribute of love is expressed in his command to love your neighbor as yourself. This command provides a foundation upon which we can affirm the objective goodness of generosity, self-sacrifice, and equality. And we can condemn as objectively evil greed, abuse, and discrimination. This raises a problem. Is something good just because God wills it, or does God will something because it is good? The answer is neither one. Rather, God wills something because he is good.